amazing day. A question I ask almost every day is, how do you stay so motivated and happy each day? Seriously, every time someone asks me this question, I stop and I think, oh, you know, if only you knew. Remember, what you see on social media isn't always 100% reality. You may have heard the quote that says, don't compare yourself to everyone else's highlighted reels. And that's exactly what social media is. You know, you see all these couples and all these travel photos and videos and all these dream jobs and things, but you don't actually know what's happening behind scenes of these people's lives. As always, I try and keep it real for you. I'm not going to post anything depressing on my pages, but you just have to know that not everyone is happy all the time. I have never met someone that's happy 24/7, and if I did, I'd congratulate them and probably ask them how they do it as well. Although I'm not necessarily happy all the time, I do define myself as a bubbly and positive person. I always try to look on the bright side of things. I thought I'd throw together a few tips to help you find happiness, I guess, if you're struggling to see the light. After what I've just said, I guess it's clear to start with, don't compare yourself to other people. If you're constantly comparing yourself to who has a better car, who has a better phone, or how someone gets to go traveling more often than you and thinks, how are you ever going to be happy? Because you're constantly comparing what they've got with what you've got or haven't got, so that you end up focusing so much on that and the negative side of it that you forget to appreciate the things that you have. Don't think that you can compare yourself to anyone else and they should compare themselves to you, because we're all different and we're all unique and that's what makes us special. Well, I think that it's an attitude choice to be happy. I choose to put that smile on my face and it usually stays there for the whole day. If you struggle to smile during the day or in the morning when you wake up, what I like to do is I wake up and I think of things I'm really appreciative of. So when you wake up in the morning, think of positive thoughts, and usually that should be enough to set you smiling. One small positive thought in the morning can change your whole outlook on a day. But if you wake up thinking, oh, I don't want to go to uni, I don't want to go to work, then of course you're going to have a bad day. Focus on the positives. Wake up in the morning and think, oh, I'm so lucky I've got a job. I'm so lucky I get to go to university, because it is a gift and there's a lot of other people that would kill to have a job like yours or to even get the chance to go to university. Carrying on from that, so complaining won't get you anything. If you're waking up each morning and you're thinking, oh, I don't want to go to work, or you're waking up and you're looking in the mirror and you're not happy with what you see, then you need to start taking action. You may not be able to change things instantly right now, but you can definitely start taking steps towards changing what you don't like. For a lot of people, they'll look at their job and they'll think, oh, you know, I can't find anything better, but they haven't even looked. With looking in the mirror and thinking, it would take me so long to lose this fat or gain that muscle and so on, so on. Time's gonna pass anyway. You may as well start acting on it and chasing those dreams. I know that sometimes things are gonna be really hard, but I just don't think complaining will help make that any easier. Only action will. A massive thing I think that a lot of people forget is to surround themselves with positive people. So if you're constantly surrounding yourself with people that are negative and dreading their lives, dreading what they're doing, how is it ever going to uplift you? So I like to surround myself with people that I can uplift, but in turn they'll return the good vibes back as well. So it may involve you cutting out a lot of people that you think are your closest friends, but in reality they're not. It's a case of, if you're all rowing in a boat, some of them are punching holes in your boat. The way I see it is, when I'm hanging out with friends, I always want to push them to be better. I want to support them, motivate them, inspire them, help them grow as people, and do whatever makes them happy. In turn, you want that back from your friends as well. So if your friends are constantly trashing your dreams, you know, if you want to start going to the gym and they're constantly begging you to go out drinking with them all the time, then do you really need them in your life? That's a common thing that a lot of people find hard to do. You know, they think that if they cut these people out of their lives, they're not going to have friends, but the truth is, you'll meet friends that will lift you so much higher. A quote I heard a while ago was that you're the average of your five friends. So if you think about who your top five friends are around you that you see every day, do you want to be like them? Are they helping you? Are they inspiring you? Are they motivating you? some of you will be thinking, oh, I can't find any positive friends in this stupid town, blah, blah, and you'll be negative about it. It's not the end of the world, you know. You can create your own positive environment. So you can watch positive YouTube channels, you can look online for positive articles, you can play sports, do things that make you happy, go to the gym, join clubs at your high school or university, whatever you're at, and try and create a positive environment so that even when these negative people are around you, you're so content and so happy, your own little bubble, that it doesn't even bother you. Thing that I find really helps me get through the tough days is listening to motivational speeches. A lot of you would have seen on my Snapchat that I listen to motivational speeches almost every day, whether it's in the morning when I'm waking up or just before I go to bed. And I find that that really lifts me up and gets me pumped for the day. Also, there's a ton of books out there that you can read to help give you motivation to either be happy or find your passions that will eventually make you happy as well. On my little list I wrote down earlier, I actually had no more focusing on the negatives, but I've kind of covered that within all my other points, just about focusing on the positive things in life. Eliminating all the negative people will usually help you to look on the positive side of things. It will be hard to eliminate these people, but eventually you'll start realizing how uplifting it can be. And most important point of why I think I'm so happy is because I appreciate the little things. The little things aren't actually that little. A lot of people are too busy focusing on getting the newest cars, having all these material things, but you're forgetting to appreciate the little things. You're so fixed on materiality that you've forgotten about the things that you're so lucky to have. A bit about me, I go to university, I ride a bike every day, I don't have a car, I wear pretty basic stuff, I don't really spend that much money on clothes ever, I don't wear makeup usually, I live pretty minimally, and yes, I do go traveling from time to time, which I do love, and it's a treat to myself. But the thing with me is, I appreciate the little things. I may complain about going to university because counting's hard. There's people that will never even get to go to primary school. I've been to Mount Everest and I've seen the kids up there that go to school, and you know, they were happy just to get a kaleidoscope as a present and some stationery, while most people here aren't even happy if they get, say, iPhone 5S instead of an iPhone 6. As bad as it is, some people will complain about not having a top model of some car, or their car has an issue with it and it's going to cost so much to fix. You know, some people never ever get the chance to even ride in a car. While you're complaining that a shop doesn't have your Diet Coke, there's people around the world that are struggling to find food and water each day. Or you're complaining that your parents keep texting you or keep calling you all the time. Just keep in mind that a lot of people aren't as fortunate as you to have family members that care about them. I know that those things are like really extreme for me to use an example, but it's just to show you that you need to appreciate the little things, because they're not that little to some people. After all that, I'm gonna pretty much contradict myself. At the end of the day, it's okay to not be happy 24/7. You literally can't smile all the time. Like, my cheeks get sore from smiling all the time. So if you are feeling sad and you are feeling down, don't feel bad about reaching out to a friend, a family member, or even someone else in society that won't judge you, and you don't have to worry about what they think. So this could just be like a counselor, someone at your workplace or your university that can help you out. It is natural to have down days, but just make sure that you try and see the light at the end of the tunnel. So you might be having a bad day, but tomorrow's a new day. You can pick yourself up, you can smile, and you can get through it. I really hope that this video helps at least one person. It is a really common question I get, and I didn't really know how to answer it because I'm not happy all the time, but I do try my best, and that's a few of the things I do to try to lift myself up. If you want any more good vibes, feel free to like this video and give me any comment suggestions below, and I'll make sure I reply. And yeah, I hope you all have a good night, good day, good morning, whatever. Sending out good vibes and hugs to everyone. Bye.